Hey, Ryan from Prisma here. And Prisma is an open source ORM and database toolkit. And it's specifically meant for TypeScript and Node.js. And that's because Prisma is all about giving you type-safe database access. And it happens to work very well in a Next.js application. So if you're a Next developer and you want to get a data layer in your application, Prisma is going to be the best way for you to do that. Why don't we take a look at how to include Prisma in a Next application? I've got this really simple blog. This is a Next.js application. It's just got a handful of blog posts, and you can go to an individual post. You can go to it based on its ID, and then it's just got the title and the excerpt and this delete button, which is a little funny for a blog. You probably won't normally see that, but that's because we want to show off some of Prisma's features. And the data that goes into this application right now is just coming from this static data set that I've got here in my data directory in post.ts. So the goal here is for us to take out this static data and replace it with a real database that uses Prisma. So to do that, we need to get Prisma into this project. What we can do here is install the Prisma tools that we'll need. I've already got them installed, but I'll show you the commands to run to install them. You would want to do npm install as a dev dependency at prisma/CLI. And so that's going to install the Prisma CLI for you. This will give you access to the commands you want to run to make Prisma do the things that it does. And then you'll want to install at prisma/client. This is going to give you the tools to do your database access. And we'll see that in just a little bit. So the Prisma client is a regular dependency and the Prisma CLI is a dev dependency. So once you have those installed, what you can do is npx prisma init. And when you run that command, you're going to get this Prisma directory. Within the Prisma directory, there are two files. We've got this .env file, and we've also got a schema.prisma file. Schema.prisma uses the Prisma schema language. And this is where we define our models. This is where we describe the tables that we want in our database. And then we can do things like relate one table to the next. And this is going to be the source of truth for your database. We'll run some migrations. We'll see how to wire up those tables. But ultimately, this is going to be where you define the shape of your database. So we can even get started in here by describing a model, and we'll call it post. This is going to be what drives our post application. We'll want to start with an ID, and we'll make that an int. So with Prisma, we've got access to various types. We can use int or string or other types that might go along with our databases. In this case, ID is going to be an int, and we want to mark it with ID to say that this is the primary key. Then we'll want to give it a default value, and we'll want to say that this is going to auto increment. So every subsequent post is just going to take on an integer value that is higher than the one before. We've got the ID, we'll want a title, which will be a string, and then we'll want the excerpt to be a string as well. That's about all we need for our model. And what we can do now is run a migration to actually get this data to go into our database. But first we want to change some configuration up for our database. Right now we're saying that the provider is a Postgres database. In this case, let's work with SQLite. SQLite is a file system database that you might be familiar with, and you can get access to it just by creating a file called dev.db, for example. So once you've got that, you can come in here and replace the URL with file dev.db, and that's going to point to our dev.db SQLite database. So once we've got that, let's save it, and let's come down to the command line. And we can run some commands to wire up this database. So let's do npx prisma migrate, and we'll want to save. We'll run the experimental flag. We have to run that flag for now. So once we get that, we want to name the migration. We'll just call this init. The next thing we want to do is npx prisma migrate up, and experimental flag we'll pass there as well. Once we do that, we will have this single table, post, in our database. So the last thing to do here is to run the Prisma generate command. And that's going to create a database access client for us. So we can do npx prisma generate. Once we do this, we can look into our node modules file and we'll see this .prisma directory. And in here is going to live a whole bunch of stuff that relates to our database. So if we search for type post, we can see the type definitions for our post type that we just defined in our Prisma model. Okay, so let's see this database through an actual client. If we go and run npx Prisma Studio, this is going to wire together a graphical user interface for our database. So we can click into our post, and right now there's no data in there, but we'll want to include some. And in fact, what we can do is we can add records directly through the user interface here. So let's go back over and we will grab some of that data. So into the data directory, maybe we'll just start with this single post. We've got the title and we can do add record. The title will go there, and the excerpts, we'll just take that from here. That goes into the excerpt spot, and we can save that change. What we get is a post with ID 1. So I've gone ahead behind the scenes and I've added in those other posts. So now we've got the four posts that we had as static data now existing in a file system SQLite database. The goal now is going to be for us to use this data to go into our application here. And the way that we'll do this is we will use the Prisma client. So let's take a look at the spots where we're accessing data. If we go into the pages directory, into index.tsx, this is using static site generation. That comes through the getStaticProps function here. And it's right here that we can actually use Prisma to access the database. And that's because this function runs on the server. It isn't a client-side thing. We don't need to worry about including database access in the browser. This function is going to run beforehand. This is a server-side thing, and it's the perfect spot for us to use Prisma. So to do that, let's do this. Let's do import Prisma client from @prisma/client. And then down here, we'll want to say that Prisma is a new Prisma client. We'll new it up. Over here in the getStaticProps, we can make a call to Prisma to get that post data. And what we can see in terms of data access, type-safe data access, we can see that right away if we just even go Prisma, and then we see what's available on it. And the first thing that we go to is post. This lines up with that post table that we've created. When we generated the Prisma clients, it put a bunch of stuff here onto our Prisma instance. And so we've got a bunch of methods that are specific to Prisma, but we've got access to our post model. And so we can say const post equals await, we'll await this, prisma.post.findMany. And so now instead of taking posts from the static data, we'll just get rid of this. We will take it from the database instead. So let's save this. And let's go back over to our application. We'll refresh this. We've got our post coming through. Perfect. We can go to an individual post if we click into it, and the ID here is going to be used to get our post and to display it. And right now that's happening in this post directory, in this ID file. And so this uses the get server-side props function, which is going to run server-side rendering. Another spot where Next takes care of a whole bunch of stuff for us on the server and then gives us the benefit, in this case, of server-side rendering. The function that I've got here is just looking for a matched post based on the posts array. It's finding it by its ID. This is another spot where we can use Prisma. So similar to what we did in the last file, we can import Prisma client from @prisma/client. And we can come into our function. Actually, just before we do that, we'll say const prisma equals a new Prisma client. And then down here in the function, the match post, it's not going to be finding from that array of posts. Instead, we're going to find from our Prisma client. So in this case, let's do const matched post equals await Prisma dot post, and then we can take a look at the methods that we've got here. We used find many for the index page. We wanted to get all of our posts. In this case, we want to find one, and we want to find it based on its ID. So to do that, we would say, I want to find it where some condition is satisfied. And the condition we want here is where the ID that we get from params, so what's after the slash, where that is equal to the post ID. So we can say where ID is equal to params.id. And what we see here, I'm actually just going to take out this old code that we're not going to need anymore. What we can see here is we've got this TypeScript error. And this error is saying that we can't actually find by params.id. And that's because when we take params.id, that's a string. And what we've got in our database is an integer for ID. So these types don't match up. And this is a spot where Prisma is protecting us in a type-safe way. It's protecting us in terms of accessing our data, but also saving data. So we, for instance, we wouldn't be able to put in something to our database that shouldn't be there in terms of type. So the fix for this is we just convert params.id to a number like that. So we should now have our matched posts, and we can take out our posts array there. Let's save this, and back over in the application, if we refresh, we still get our post. We can test out another one. Perfect, we're still finding everything as we want to. The last spot that we've got here is an API route. This is another spot where you can use the Prisma client to access your data. And in this case, we want to delete some data. So we will import Prisma client, just like we've seen before, from @PrismaClient. And let's new it up down here, cons Prisma equals a new Prisma client. And then we want to take the ID that comes through in the request that's coming through on the query, and we want to find something in our database and delete it. So we can do await. We'll actually do await Prisma post delete, and we want to delete where ID is equal to post ID. Once again, the types don't match up here. Post ID is a string, whereas ID is an integer, and so we just want to convert this to a number. Okay, so we should now have our handler complete to delete that post. So let's save that, and let's come back over to our application, and let's say we want to delete post number two. We can delete it. We get back to the index page, post number two is gone. And if we go to the studio, we can refresh. And of course, post number two is gone. So this has been a really quick tour of how you can use Prisma in your Next.js application. And again, there are a few spots that you might want to use it. You might want to use it in your API routes. You also might want to use it in your getStaticProps function. This again is something that runs on the server. So perfectly fine to use Prisma here. And you also might want to use it in the get server side props function. Again, another function that runs on the server and perfectly safe to use Prisma. So if you want more information on how you can use Prisma in your Next.js application, head over to prisma.io. You'll see plenty of examples there, and reach out to us on Twitter. We'd be happy to help you out.